Hey everyone, this is your host Chris Jeep from Blurred's Eye View. And if you haven't heard about Anchor, it's the easiest way to make a podcast. Here, let me explain. First, it's free. You definitely can't beat that. Plus, there's creation tools that allow you to record and edit your podcast right from your phone or your computer. Anchor will distribute your podcast for you so it can be heard on Spotify, Apple Podcasts, and many more. You can make money from your podcast with no minimum listenership, and it's everything you need to make a podcast and more. Download the free Anchor app or go to anchor.fm to get started. Hey everybody, this is Blurred's Eye View After Dark. I'm your host, Chris Fury. Along with me is Candy B and DC. How's it going, everybody?
Gotta hit a 20 dabs on him. It's good.
20 dabs. Hey, after the week we've had. If you don't know by now, Blurred's Eye View After Dark is the show where we talk pretty much about the spoiler-rich type shows and movies that's been shown. So, you know, if you caught it, great.
Also, we get kind of tired because it's dark.
It's dark. Ooh. It's naughty time.
All bets are off.
All bets are off. Let me rephrase. It's naughty time.
Oh, there it's the nasty time.
Mr. Nasty.
We'll be back in 5 minutes.
Let me start it off by playing this. Hold on.
Here's the one.
Motherfucker. That's all I got to say. Sam Jackson, you were right. Motherfucker. This episode, we're going to be talking about Justice League, the Zack Snyder's version of the Justice League, as well as the Falcon and Winter Soldier, if time permits. It all depends. If we can get through the praise that is the
The glory,
the honor, and the praise. Say what you will. Say that it's too long. Say whatever, but I guarantee you what you won't say is that it's a horrible film. Because this
shouldn't
film
say anything's too long when you've been waiting like 6 years for it. No. Yeah, I mean,
no. What you want?
That's what years. She said.
Right. like, no, we waited this long. This better be long.
It better be worth the wait. It better be long as shit.
Where do we even begin with this movie? Damn.
At the beginning.
Yeah, let's start there. As most stories start, they start at the beginning.
The beginning of the first one.
The beginning. You know, the other version, as me and DC have been calling it, the other guys. It left a kind of a rancid taste in our mouth.
It's bad date that ended with bad sex, and you were just like, what the fuck? And then they come back, like, you know, 4 years later, and they got hot again. You're like, I wonder if it's worth taking this chance. And then you get 4 hours worth of pleasure. Yeah! Yeah! Yeah, that's what it was.
So, I don't know if we're going to dissect the entire 4 hours, because that's going to be a long-ass show. But what we will dissect is the moments that really stood out so that we've seen so far. I know Candy B has seen at least half of it. Yeah. And she's seen it in part, but her cat-like sleep pattern has been thrown off.
Man, listen, I was mad. I fell asleep. Cause I was like, all right, I'm about to watch this. is 1 a.m. And I don't know about y'all, but even how I got through Lovecraft Country and other stuff, I like catching stuff about that 12 to 2 o'clock in the morning hour. Yeah, I don't know why. I just think I'm uninterrupted.
It's when there's less people. There's less people streaming on the streaming services, as we've learned in the past.
Nobody's hitting you up. You're not distracted. My kids sleep, so it's kind of like good. So I know after we're done tonight, I'm gonna go ahead and do that.
I'm literally watching it like in increments right now. And
I will ask questions.
I want to know from you guys. And like this movie, questions will be answered.
So pretty much. So if you haven't watched it or whatever, you don't want nothing spoiled, like go away.
By the time you see this episode, it's already live on YouTube. But if you're catching it on Monday, or you'll be listening to the audio version of it on Monday, then guess what? Nigga, you're late.
Short. Jared Leto's Joker, like as great as everyone's saying, because people were like,
No. Okay. I wouldn't say he's great because here's the thing, he looks fine, but he's not. We're so used to a maniacal type of Joker that he's playing it too calm.
He's a therapist.
The verbiage is there, the speech is there, but it's the delivery.
We need a bit of that lunacy that's there, because I think that's what in the comic books make Joker, in my opinion, scary, because someone that's truly unpredictable is frightening.
Yeah,
you don't know what they're willing to do to you, to themselves, to
you still know just from the speech that he gives, but at the same time, it's too calm.
Okay,
it's too calm, you know. And you're just like, I don't know. Bless you. The other stuff. She's just had a little sneeze. People, calm down.
Oh, no.
Coronavirus.
He's played a little too calm. And Jared Leto's actually a really good actor. He's really a great actor.
He really is.
You know, I think he's reading it differently. I think.
Do you think he's probably still in that Morbius role? Because you remember he's filming.
It was very theatrical. Shakespeare in the Park.
It was
like big words, a lot of $5 words, it was like.
And I think Batman was more upset that he didn't know what those $5 words were, opposed to who's saying them. So
Batman was like, what the fuck are you talking about? Where's my dictionary? Speak English.
Watch the next words that come out of your mouth. That's why he said that.
He was like, you better measure your next words, because I can't comprehend what the fuck you're saying.
Because I went to public school in Gotham.
Right.
Still known fact.
I dropped out in 11th grade. That's why I beat people up.
We'll start at the beginning. This movie
is sponsored by Tiramisu.
Yeah, it's a great start. Let's put it like this. The other version, and I've said it before, the other version pretty much opened up with Batman in Gotham chasing down a thug, trying to get a parademon to show up. Now, that alone was a question mark, because it's like, when did this happen for him to know that he's looking for a parademon? When did he know he was looking for a mother box? When did all that shit happen? This version, Zack Snyder's version, cuts that entire fucking thing out. There's no need for it. It makes no sense. And the scene where they show Steppenwolf go after the mother box on Themyscira, that was an amazing scene.
I saw it in your face. I was like, was it amazing?
That was an amazing scene.
It was in game. It was an in-game level battle.
Yeah, okay. Damn it. Like, look.
I mean, you had a lot of moving parts.
Those girls, excuse me, rephrase, those women,
them badasses,
they weren't playing. Like, they were, like, literally, Queen Hippolyta, she says, when he says, I will bathe in your fear, and she tells her warrior, she says, she was like, daughters of Themyscira, tell them about fear. And they were like, they all chanted, we know no fear.
Oh,
and shit. They all were in battle mode. And
well, Bob,
they,
that-
They were on his ass. They literally, there was a point where they pretty much dogpiled on the rabbit. They dogpiled his ass.
I'm not
and
mad
they
at couldn't that.
And they but, I'm no, like
I was hearing people said they wanted when they watched Wonder Woman 1984. And mm-hmm. we're gonna go back and we're gonna do all the rest of the stuff. We want to see some badass moments. And to me, from how you're describing it, this is what I wish Marvel had done when they decided to okay, we're gonna show a woman, a power woman movement or whatever. Like make it make sense, one, and then make it badass.
And they did. That whole scene was a very badass moment. Like, I mean, it was still even in the other version, there was some tight moments, but they cut out so much of it. That, like in Zack Snyder's vision, there's a scene where
the completion,
yeah, right when he literally has the box in his hand and they are lighting his ass up with arrows. And for one, Steppenwolf looks like a real badass in this one. They made him look humanized in the last version.
Yeah, he has some pretty eyes. I want to be, you know what I'm saying?
Caught in.
Yeah, like he had some, like they made him to. He was like a human as Jason Bateman.
Oh my god, yeah.
It was like this weird, you know what I'm saying? Like the look they gave him. In the other one, he had like these dead ass eyes, but in this one, his eyes was alive. You know what I'm saying? It looked like he was.
It looked like the color was dancing in his eyes a bit.
Yeah, he had that sparkle of but that he wanted to do some maniacal shit.
Yeah, he's holding the box, and he looks over. Now, imagine this scene, and this is what DC is talking about. It was like Endgame. Remember when Cap broken in half? He's got the hammer. He looks up. Whole army of Thanos is coming down. Remember that scene? Now take that scene and have Steppenwolf holding the mother box. And he looks over, and the entire army of Themyscira is coming over the heels.
I know that's fucking right.
And this was the backup. I was just like, oh, they about to light your ass up. You need to leave.
You need to
leave now.
Oh, no.
That's what I'm feeling on the inside.
But, yeah, they redemption. This is, speaking of redemption, this is redemption right here. Hold on. These two totally fucking redeemed.
And that makes me feel better about him even getting his own movie because I know they were really pushing Flash.
Yeah.
And I was like, y'all not gonna do this like I did the first time. Nobody yeah, would
they,
do that.
They totally redeemed. Flash's scenes are very beautifully shot.
Yeah.
And you know how he looked like he was running and he was flailing. He looked kind of like a 2-year-old trying to run through the story.
Right.
None of that. He didn't have that look. He wasn't a 2-year-old running through the store or anything. They give you Cyborg's backstory.
I heard a lot of men was going to therapy with Cyborg. I thought yeah. I heard that
right. They if you finally sit down, you're like, even if you're a fan and you know his backstory, the fact that you didn't get his backstory is what pissed you off. And you're just like, why?
I think this has to feel better for people too, especially given that the actor who plays him has been right this whole time on top of that.
Right.
On top of the movie coming out and everybody loving it. It's like, oh yeah, I was right about this. Vindication is definitely on the way for my whole career because when you're blackballed like that in Hollywood, and I really, like, the jokes aside about Monique, I really feel like she's right about her situation, what happened to her. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think she's right about her approach, but I'm like, I'm more than sure this happened to you and you were kind of bullied out that circle because how you go from being an Oscar winner to not getting any roles or offers or anything.
Yeah.
Somebody in the industry said, we don't fuck with her. And then that's a wrap for you on TV shows, dog commercials, whatever.
Like, dog commercials. Y'all.
Like, he gave you light bulb commercials right now.
Right. And it's a shame. Right. It's a damn shame. She can't get it.
Queens of comedy to nothing.
To nothing. So I like that for career, especially more so for him, because it's hard out here for a pimp in the colors, that this is going to do better for him. And it's like, I'm not difficult to work with. I'm not problematic on set. Like, that's not how this is at all.
So, yeah, between Flash and Cyborg getting their redemption. These are like their redemption stories for real. There is one other piece that, and I'm gonna show you this. You're gonna be like, what? But all I'm gonna say, I'm gonna start it off with saying the whole damn time.
Get the fuck out of here.
You think it's a game? Get fired on these bitches one time.
Good, perfect timing. That's good.
Oh, God, this is terrible. Somebody, please. Find Ja Rule. Get hold of this motherfucker so I can make sense of all this.
She can't make sense.
The whole damn time.
That is my boo. Like, wow.
In plain sight.
In plain sight. In fucking, like,
wait a minute.
Yeah. And this is what me and DC were saying. We were just like,
original actor too playing him.
Yeah. And that's what me and DC were saying. We were like, fuck. If we got that in this, what the fuck did we miss in Man and Steel and BVS? What was missing?
There's probably a lot to miss in BVS, because that to me was a lot to take in. By the time they were just going through layer and layer and layer of floor when they were fighting, I was so tired and there was so much that had already dumped out of my head. Where if there was something there like that, I wouldn't have caught it. And I never watched the movie again. So I damn sure wasn't going to catch it on the replay.
But see, after watching Zack Snyder's Justice League, after watching this.
The real Justice League.
TNT was actually showing BVS back to back that same night. And I was talking to DC because he was just catching up on Justice League. And I said, I'm looking at this movie in a whole new light now. Like, what else was missing? Like, what else was possibly missing? Because he still directed that film, but obviously the execs made him cut some shit out.
Right.
So now I'm looking at it totally different, because guess who else? I don't have his picture, but guess who else redeemed themselves? Fucking Lex Luthor.
Oh, that's a big one. Because that
it completely, I'm like, I get it now. Fuck it. I get it now. I'm like, you took so much from the man, and I mean Zack Snyder, you took so much from him instead of you allowing him to tell this story that you said, no, we don't need that. We don't need this. We don't.
Essentially, DC kicked themselves in the dick with this whole fiasco.
That's really sad.
And I say that because you had Man of Steel, which had promise. Batman vs. Superman, you can tell there were some things left out and there were some creative control issues. Wonder Woman kind of saved the day. Aquaman was there to really pull up the rear. And then you had this fucking flip-flop of a Justice League movie, which you can tell they wanted to get rid of Zack Snyder. As Chris said, you know, they wanted to get rid of him from beginning. Get-go. You blowing money. We don't do things this way. Fuck your vision. And then his daughter committed suicide, and that was their out.
Mm-hmm.
So then they brought in Josh Whedon, who totally wet the bed. Like, I'm talking, like, really bullshitted this movie. Like, he was like,
I don't know.
Let's say Chris Marvel was like, go fuck they shit up and come back.
Yeah, we were like, it's like, it's got to be a theory. Like,
anyway, how was he able to do that?
Yeah like, you worked for Marvel.
Like, Marvel paid him. Like, Marvel paid, like, look, whatever they're paying, we would pay you double to go over there and fuck it up.
Fuck that shit up. So now you're getting paid two times. But I say that to say this. What we got in Zack Snyder's cut, I said this before. If you compare the 2 hours, the original Justice League was 2 hours. Zack Snyder at 2 hours was only half aware at the place of half of the original. They were at two mark at 2 hours.
They were under the harbor.
That's 2 hours at the Zack Snyder cut. So you tell it that the whole first 2 hours was him going back and pretty much Deadpooling what happened in Justice League. He was going back and erasing and retelling the story as it should have been told the first time, but they dropped the ball on it. So then you got another 2 hours of just action.
Which you'd want most movies like that to be anyway.
Unless you're DC, and then you was like, you know what? We want to give them this cookie cutter. It's like, well, we're after dark. DC wants to have missionary sex. Like, that's their style of making movies. They want to be able to look you in the eye and give you the same boring thing night after night. That's what they do.
The same boring thing.
They don't want to change positions. They don't want to try nothing freaky. They don't want to put ice nowhere. They just want to do missionary sex.
How my man said, how Dave Chappelle said, he was like, when he dressed up like the white dude, he was like, let me just pull it through my pajama bottom.
Oh, yeah. Like, they want to pull it through the pants. They want to just slide you to the side. They don't want to do nothing adventurous.
He didn't want to completely naked. That's why that pajama.
Right.
Yeah. Well, that's the same with DC. They don't want to get fully butt naked. They don't want to do something as perceived as a risk because they've been playing this Boy Scout thing. Like, they've been, like, and it's what's killing them. Because Marvel's out here butt naked, raw dogging, and putting legs on heads and
experimenting.
Taking chances. Like, I don't want to use that kind of metaphor, but that's like DC is really, they have really, and I don't even like that my name initials is like that because I don't want to be associated with the bitches like that. But anyway, I like Superman still to this day, but still, like, they just want to give you this same boring ass kind of way of doing things, this cookie cutter.
Yeah, nothing's vanilla. Exciting as it should be for them. And that's what's upsetting is it's like you have the content. You
have the characters
to be so diverse and so interesting, and it's not even going to be a hard pull because some of these stories are tragic. And I thought, like, you do something where you're the answer for what something Marvel is putting out. Like, they throw something out there and you throw something out there, not literally throw something out there, because a lot of y'all have more characters. So why not match that up where it's like, oh, they're doing Deadpool, well, let's do Lobo.
Yeah. They're afraid to compete.
It makes so much sense to have a Lobo movie and to do it right, especially after the success of Deadpool. You can do that now. So
yeah, that's why I was late to this, because I was watching Deadpool. I could watch that again. I could watch Deadpool 1 and 2 religiously. If Deadpool is on, I'm stopping. But they don't want to compete. That's the problem. One, they don't want to do anything adventurous.
They
do not want to compete. Because Marvel's already lapped them.
Yeah, several times. Because, when you turn around and have a blockbuster such as the first Avengers, which was
Let's start with Iron Man.
That part.
Yeah.
Because you had Superman Returns. A couple years later, you had Iron Man.
Mm-hmm.
Iron Man set it off.
It really did.
Well, actually, Blade set it off.
Yeah,
I want to correct myself. Blade set it off.
We know Blade set it off, but
their cinematic universe, Iron Man was their golden goose.
Exactly. And for Blade to do well, that did open the door for Iron Man. But Iron Man had to perform well, so we knew, okay, this wasn't a one-off thing. Yeah. And after that, did so well because I'll say to this day, Robert Downey Jr., aka Kirk Lazarus, it will never not be Tony. He is forever. He's real life Tony Stark. There is no difference between those two.
Oh yeah. That he still has that beard. I did an interview with who was it? I want to say Jimmy Fallon or somebody. He still has the Tony Stark look.
Because that's him.
That's him.
And for Marvel to do such a great job of saying, we're not just going to cast people that we feel like are the character. We're going to get actual thespians up here. We're going to get people that can really act to really give these characters life.
Not only that, they picked the right people who embody the qualities of those people. Yeah, Tony Stark was kind of arrogant, troubled, who kind of found his way towards the end. Robert Downey Jr., his whole first half of his career was fucking in and out of prison.
And drugs and drinking.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So they fought characters, Chris Evans, the typical Boy Scout type of guy. They fought people who not only embody those roles, but who lived that kind of, that walked that line. You know what I mean? It was kind of like they can relate with the character better than anybody else could have.
And it's very rarely you watch something and it involves character acting and you really feel like you're this person more than, I honestly don't know who Chris is. It's like, I know who Captain is.
I can't tell you shit about Chris Evans.
Yeah, Chris Evans doesn't exist. You are our Cap. Like, this is who you are now because you guys have done that well in these roles. It's like, I can't think of you as anything else. And
look, I follow this guy on Twitter. I follow him on Twitter. And hell, I'm like, damn, is there any wrong you can? I'm like, at this point, I'm like, somebody's probably tried to find dirt on you and can't
there
find
is none. That's America's ass. It's
you know how he subtly gets into anything activism-wise? Because him and Chris Pine are very much allies.
Yeah,
to the cause, and it's just like, wow, you don't seem like the type of person who's like want to talk about it but not be about it.
He does definitely that. He does
definitely love him some chocolate, caramel, toffee,
French vanilla. It don't matter.
You love him some chocolate.
Equal opportunity for it, and we're okay.
That's America. Yeah, I'm cool with it. I mean, there's enough of them.
I'm like, dude, like, dude, you literally
black asses.
You literally embody what Captain America is, and I salute you, sir. And you are invited to the barbecue. I mean,
yes, he can definitely come because and Tony probably gonna be on the grill.
Like. Yes, so Tony be on the grill. Hey,
Cap, what do you want? How do you want your burger? Okay. Nah, let's do
none
it.
Of that right. pink. None of that pink.
Like, another pink. Well done, American cheese. Like very much that guy.
Yeah, he definitely put my bun on top with my little pickle and cheese.
Tony, can you toast that before you put it? Thanks.
Brioche only.
Brioche. Fresh brioche. It is a fresh loaf because he had to cut it.
Yeah, with that big ass low lathe things you cut bread with. Back to DC. Okay, we got way off topic. That's what
we do, though. We're like,
that's what I love about this crew. So where were we? Oh yeah. Zack Snyder. They DC don't take risks. Like this cut, you could tell was a risk they took because the fans was finally fucked up and fed up about it.
Yeah.
Because the rumors that were like, this wasn't the original movie from the stars telling you this wasn't what we had at first. And Zack Snyder saying, this ain't what I directed. This ain't what I started filming.
Jason Momoa said it. Gal Gadot said it.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So people was like, this film that y'all got is complete and utter bullshit. That ain't what we filmed. That ain't what was supposed to come out.
Right.
What we originally had was a big ass jump off the porch moment for us.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean, it was supposed to be that thing that got them back in the race.
Exactly. That's the pressure I know I put on this movie, and I try to do my best with not doing that. Walking into a film so I can truly enjoy it.
I did it. But I was like, this like be that.
I was like, no, you guys have no choice but to come with it. And then when I was seeing all the people being cast, and you see the little photos behind the scene, you're like, oh, okay, that this Justice League.
The cast was amazing. At least in the Zack Snyder cut, the cast was phenomenal.
Exactly. Like
people that they put in them parts was the same thing Marvel did, where these people was meant to play that role.
Made sense, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean, it made sense. But the I'm gonna call it the Josh Whedon cut. That bullshit, I'm gonna put his name on it. That bullshit wasn't what it was supposed to be, and you can tell by the way it was either one rushed, and two, it the way it was edited, the way it was cut, the way it just looked.
The script was changed.
It was rough.
The editing was rough. That Superman thing.
The transitions were like what.
What? Like, how did you get here? Like, he went from Gotham to a prison. Like, how the fuck? Wait, what bus did y'all take?
At the end, I really was like, wait a minute. When did y'all move here? Because the editing, it wasn't seamless. I was like, what's happening? And then the way Marvel be shooting their scenes, it's almost like they got the damn camera on your fighter.
Yeah.
And you're doing it with, like, you can see everything and how they edit it.
Comic book style. You can see the editing is different.
This is the problem. Like we said, like, DC will not take the risk. Perfect example. One of Marvel's biggest risks after the Avengers was, guess what? Now we're doing Guardians of the Galaxy. And people were like, who?
Yeah.
Nobody cares. Like, they've been in the series, they've been in the books for years, but nobody cares. They do now.
They made you care. That's the thing.
Like, and they were just like, you want to talk about ambition? Oh, we're going to throw a dart. What's the next movie?
But
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Well, then when you have people up there like Glenn Close, I'm like, y'all got real ass actors on these films.
Yeah,
you got Bench Cumber,
Valencia del Toro, like,
Pinkle Slice playing Doctor Strange.
Mr. Cumberbatch, Pickle Slice. When I figured out he was joining, I was like, I cannot believe, and a lot of it for actors, right? We know the bottom line is money, and it's gonna be a hit when you do something like this. But I like that they're not playing it like how Scorsese like blasted, kind of like it's just like, oh, that's not real acting, those aren't real movies. Like, no, you have real thespians that have done, like,
Oscar. Well, you got work. British actors coming
British over actor, here, okay? Because they do the theater, so they decided to put a cape on.
Join us. See, that's the thing, though. That's why Marvel has lapped DC, because not only are they not afraid to take risks, but they're not afraid to take movies that nobody wanted at the time, but make you want them.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They make us care about introduce characters a lot of people don't know, because of course you always know you can probably name 5-10, I think, on average most Americans can. But would I have said that Star-Lord would have been in my top 10 had I not seen this movie? Like, it's like, no, I didn't know.
You'd be like, who the fuck is
and
that
then the
guy?
Fact that Groot was the original baby. Okay, Groot was the OG Baby Yoda of kind of fascination of what is this character? This is really Vin Diesel. And this is all he says for the whole movie, and it just
right.
it,
his whole it, life.
I mean, it's the question.
Oh no, he said we are Groot.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, but, he did.
One time.
But here's the thing. You know, you see so much stuff blossoming from Zack Snyder's vision. You see the friendship between Flash and Cyborg forming.
Buddy cops.
You see it. Like, and it is. It's like buddy cops. And you see it forming. Like, you could tell one is really the kind of happy-go-lucky one, and the other one, he's dealing with so much tragedy. But the happy-go-lucky one is trying to bring him around.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like this, like there's a scene, and it's not really giving nothing away. There's a scene where they figure out they need to bring Superman back, and they're at his grave, and Flash literally says, you know, I can do this like in a nanosecond.
Yeah, he said we both could do this really, we really can get fast. This,
and he's like, no. And it was like, I'm like, it reads so much deeper with their conversation, and like they literally start depending on each other
for they better do that with each other, because you sure can't with the rest of your team.
Right. Like, they really are getting it. And all that extra jokey joke stuff that, like, they had Bruce doing, and nope, none of that. Goodbye.
They took out Do You Bleed from Superman?
Yeah.
Oh, thank you, because did we need that?
No.
That was almost up there with Holly Berry's awful Stormline. I was just like...
Oh, yeah.
I think y'all just wanted to use that for, like, a trailer bite, because I think in a trailer with all the hype, it was, like, maybe sounding good.
What line was that?
The Do You Bleed?
Do you know what happens to a frog that's hit by lightning?
Never mind. I forgot about that.
Yeah, everybody in the theater had the same.
Totally blocked that out until now.
Everybody in the theater had the same look. They were just like, what happens to, is it some frogs do that we didn't know? And then the same thing as everything else.
Crazy good answer. Right. Something she learned in Africa that was like something we don't know. And then no.
Nothing.
But, expectations.
Damn. But yeah, DC. I'm not putting this on DC. Let me run this back. Oh. Not DC. This ain't DC.
Spike cherries.
Oh, Spike cherries. Yeah. Well,
yeah.
I know DC quit his job and got another job, and he's just been living his best life. He's been happy.
I got another car. Got an Apple.
You got a new car. Watch,
Nike Plus. Thank you. Life.
He is living life. He's eating cherries.
Alcohol infused cherries.
He's just missing the people fanning him with the leaves. Right.
That's the only thing I need. Like, I just need one little girl in a bikini down here, Princess Leia style, just hit me with the fan.
And when you say little girl, he mean of age, because I know
of age. Oh, hey, oh, yeah.
A grown woman.
I need a grown little woman, not like a midget, but like, you know, she's like about 5'6", you know what I'm saying?
You know, you know how these
just small in stature. Can I can read it. I can see it tomorrow. DC likes little girls fanning her. Now I'm canceling on Facebook like Derek Jackson. But anywho, you didn't hear that?
I didn't know what happened.
Put it out there. Okay. My man was out here giving women advice, and he out here sleeping with other women in his wife's bed.
Oh, it's like somebody got receipts.
Oh, yeah. You said receipts.
Because, you know, I be trying to see a video like Kevin Hart, like, we got receipts.
Hello, microphone. So anyway, my man out here giving advice, and you out here busting out internet fan booty.
Now, wait a minute. Was this, like, recently, or... Because him and his wife only been married 4 years, so was this, like, he cheated for sure?
This is recent, man.
Recently. It just
I gotta go to the shade room. I ain't hear nothing about that.
They are on it.
Let me say this. Allegedly.
Oh, I forgot.
So I don't, you know what I'm saying? I don't want to incur the wrath of... Jackson's
upset. I actually got to meet him. He's really nice.
Jackson? I mean, Deshaun Watson? Derek Jackson?
Yeah. I saw him in New Orleans. I have pictures.
I never liked him. Like, you can't be...
I don't have a problem with him because some of the stuff he says, just like Kevin Samuels, who I like his content too, some of the stuff they say is right. When you can take your little ego and emotions out of it, some of it is right about men and women. I think what people are bothered by is
the holier than now. Yeah, anybody that's like you perfect.
Anybody that can come across like I'm doing everything right and you're not, on top of, and I know a lot of men wouldn't want to admit this, on top of he's a good looking guy and you know your woman is on his page talking about yes, amen, all in the comments, and you feel threatened.
All the while this nigga busting down man cheeks in his wife's bedroom.
He's a handsome guy and then they bother. But then I'm
like, I wasn't bothered by them. It was just the whole I'm better than you because I feel this way, but all the while you out here busting cheeks in your wife's bed while she gone.
Again, I'm gonna go to the shade room because, like we said, allegedly, I don't know, but
that's all I'm saying. You can't be Jesus and out here playing Paul.
Or I kind of feel like if you're gonna put your business out, if you're gonna put your business out there, put it all out there. If you
that's what I'm saying. Out, like I'm not perfect. I'm not gonna sit up here and pretend to tell people I'm perfect. I can't give you advice like I'm perfect. I can tell you some real shit from experience. But I can't tell you some shit like, yeah, all women are queens and you should be appreciated. That is true. But then you out here busting down internet booty in your wife's bed. So you contradicting what you're saying. You feel me? Well, you can't be Jesus on camera.
He's contradicting
what Paul in the pulpit.
He's contradicting what he's saying for people that want to take everything he says as Bible. If Derrick Jackson said the sky is blue, but he cheated on his wife, but he talks about weather all the time and now people don't like him anymore or whatever, it doesn't change that the sky is
blue. We've got no time for excuses.
Bottom line is, you can't give people relationship advice if your relationship ain't perfect.
We talked about this. Yes. Wait a minute. Nobody's relationship is perfect. One. Two.
Exactly.
Two.
So you say you shouldn't be giving relationship advice.
Can give you advice, but to my opinion, it doesn't mean you believe everything they say. Again, some of the stuff that he said is fucking true. Some of it is right. So I'm not
going to say the shit Trump said was true too.
Nothing now. That's stupid.
Some of the shit Hitler said was true too.
That's stupid. So let's not, following somebody is totally different than saying, hey, what you said here was right. The people that are following, worshiping him, that's the problem.
That is the problem. It's a lot of women out here. I done seen some women out here like Derrick Jackson said, I deserve better.
That's a big problem. You do not want
Derrick Jackson. That nigga ain't paying a goddamn bill in this house.
Basically, and you don't want to be in your man's face talking about another person like that.
Yeah, I get up at 4 a.m. and come home at 5 p.m. You telling me Derrick Jackson, this nigga in a motherfucking Armani suit. I got blisters on these hands, woman.
Where's my blisters on these fingers. My Stewie clip. I need my Stewie clip.
You got fake Armani suits and shit. But anywho.
But the girl part of me
is always kind of here for someone being torn down on the internet just a little bit. Not everybody, just some people.
Well, in this case,
he deserved it.
In this anywho. Case, we're tearing down Josh, but you know, whatever.
Well, he tore himself down, apparently.
Josh Jackson.
Yeah, he been taking he been taking losses.
Derek Weeden sounds legit though.
The entire month of March, he's been taking
like an asshole. Derek Weeden.
That do sound like an asshole.
Josh Jackson.
Josh Jackson sound like a nigga.
Like a nigga that was in the NBA for like 2 seconds and got to a fight and kicked him out the league. Josh Jackson. Oh, that nigga got to a fight. They kicked him out the league.
Josh Jackson definitely sounds like some pimp who left a couple of families out there and he sell fur coats and Euclid.
Got these coats for you, young blood.
They stop you in the Home Depot parking lot, be like, hey man, your girl.
Or them fake ass gold chains. Hey, say young blood. He opened his say young blood.
Got the tag. What size
are you, brother? About a he already gonna know a size and just throw that shit at you.
You about a 32 long, ain't you, young blood?
They do say that. They say that shit.
You look like you can figure hey, like, hey, man. Meet me out here in about 20 minutes. I got something for you.
About an 18 in the neck. I got this good gold chain.
You be like, how did you know that, nigga? Isn't that scary? How you guess somebody?
Nigga, you ain't even seen the whole circumference of my neck, my nigga. How the fuck you know?
Neck size is like, are you a killer?
Taking
like,
half my neck and then multiplying it by two? That's a math I can't do.
His head looks like it's going to fit a freezer about 12 by...
You look like a good 42 by 62 box if I had to bury you. I'm just saying.
If he's blood. Measuring you, yeah.
Like that same Van Helsing, he can measure like you.
Oh my God.
You know what? But you know, but here's my thing. I don't trust somebody who wants to critique a movie who likes Scott Summers. That's my advice from a motherfucker who likes Scott Summers to try to tell me about a movie.
Well,
that's all I can say. But them the type of motherfuckers that get married and take their wife's last name like Scott Summers would. Like Scott Gray.
Not only for my mom, because you know she did it too.
Scott Gray.
Sound like old T.
but anyway, that's my soapbox for the day. I can't trust a motherfucker who likes Scott Summers to ride for him to tell me how a movie should be.
But at any rate, sound like some Facebook tea.
Just so we was joking around with, but at any rate,
we were joking.
Yeah,
allegedly. Anywho, so
still my man, though. Still my man. But we just got to put.
I'm just saying. I don't trust. Maybe it's the tequila talking, but I don't trust the motherfucker who likes Scott Summers to tell me how my movie should be. I've been waiting on this movie since I heard about it because I like Superman, I like Batman, I like DC before I liked it Marvel. But after Superman Returns, they dropped the ball for me, and I kind of fell back on them. So it's kind of personal to me that this movie did well.
Mm-hmm.
Because I mean, like DC, and I want to see them.
Here's the thing. Would you have seen this film if it was in a theater? And
would I have went? Hell yes. I would have. Okay. I went.
Now that would have been based off of
curiosity. Were people not watching this in the theater? Because I remember going to the theater to see the first one.
Here's the thing. People went to see the first one. But the time that was in the theater, it made money. But the money that it made at the end of its duration in the movie theater should have been the money it made in its first month.
True.
So they say, it made this amount of money for, let's just say it made over, I'll just say $1 billion in the three, four months that's in the theater. But it should have cleared that within the first month.
Mm.
You know, let's just say, you know, because look at Black Panther. Look at Avengers Endgame.
You got movies like Easy doing a Billy. You can't have something come out and it not
go. And it just like, oh, we met that mark. Yeah, you like, oh like, yeah, we made over. Later. Yeah, we made over like, we made $1 million over a month. Damn, dude, you didn't make that in the week?
Listen, the weekend. The box office, including China, movies be at fucking $34 million.
Yeah. You know, so you
and that's after weekend.
That's your first date. That's your Wednesday to Thursday to Friday sales. That's 3 days. So, you know, I mean, like we said it earlier, like I would have gone to see it in the theater. Four hours or not. I would have gone to see it. I went to go see the other version. I would have gone to see this one in the theater. And is, you know, sitting back and the stuff that's being broken down and stuff that's actually explained that makes more sense, like Lex. Remember in the other version, Lex is in a jail cell and he's talking about, oh, the god is dead and all this other stuff. And you're just like, what the fuck has
been wrong?
They show how he would know that.
And they also show that bell being rung, literally. Yeah.
I'm like, okay, you leave out key moments that make sense
for you. But at the beginning of the end, remember the end of Batman vs Superman, how he dies. You know, why'd you do the quotation mark?
No,
she did the quotation mark that threw me off.
Go ahead.
Okay, so the end of Batman vs Superman when Superman died.
The death scene.
They show in this version how Lex knew about what happened because as he screamed, you see the sound waves go across the world and the galaxy.
Mm-hmm.
So Superman's last screams, you can see visually.
It was his death scream. Yeah, and they was like, for some, it woke up the
crazy Steppenwolf. In the movie.
Yeah, so that's why Steppenwolf knew to come to Earth, because they were afraid to come to Earth because of Superman. His death woke the boxes with his scream. So you see this, and it's a beautiful. Now the way they did this is beautiful, because you see these waves of his scream just going out through the world, mm-hmm. out to the stars, out into the cosmos. Like you see this scream, and it starts waking these boxes. So that's how they knew Ding the God
the
is
God
dead.
Is dead. Yeah.
Wow.
That it explains it in this one scene, and this is the beginning.
And Lex was in the ship.
Still.
The Kryptonian ship, Steel, tinkering around with all the science, and he sees Steppenwolf, like the computer is showing him the mother boxes. This is how he knows. We didn't get that in the other version.
Yeah,
we didn't get none of that explanation. So it's just like, man, you just rambling about. Like, now you still look like the dude that's been rambling the entire freaking movie.
Right.
Opposed to, oh, this is more explained now.
That would have been a lot cooler by the time we got to the end of that film anyway, because shit.
Yeah. Like,
Wonder Woman showed up. We were like,
they start this at this is the beginning of the movie. They start off with Superman's death or him dying. They show the whole scene, and it plays from there. And I'm like, fuck, you're already. Like, I watched it Thursday, and I'm watching it again today. When I watched it Thursday, I was 20 minutes in, and I was like, this is it. This is what we should have gotten.
That mark that you said, a lot of people, now that I'm on the Twitters, a lot of people were tweeting and saying, I had to pause the movie. I'm about at the 30-minute mark, whatever, but I'm just letting y'all know this shit is it. They're like, That was 30 minutes in. That's how I knew. I was like, oh, my God, I'm so happy for Zach.
Like, yeah, I got to 2 hours. It was like, yeah, I need to take a break. But at the same time, this shit is fucking, because like I said, you get to just compare 2 hours of both movies. The original at 2 hours, the son bitch going off. 2 hours of the Snyder cut, you're just at the scene where they're underneath the bridge fighting, and the missile hits, and that's where I pause it. That's 2:05. I can remember that. 2:05, the 2-hour 5-minute mark. I paused it. That's the scene where they're getting back into the Nightcrawler and trying to go up the wall, and Aquaman just showed up. 2 hours in. The Josh Whedon cut. That's the end of the movie. They're showing credits, roll credits.
Yeah,
I mean, so there was so much in that first in 2 hours of the Snyder cut that, like, not only changed but showed so much more that was supposed to be in the original.
Mm-hmm.
So that just alone let me know that this is
a totally different first place. I've seen people say it's essentially the same movie. No, it's not really. It's not. It really is.
I haven't seen that. Who was saying that?
That's what people saying that. Yeah, it's like, there's no difference. I can't tell what they change.
I'm like, bitch, is you blind? Bitch, you miss a mark.
Like, you may have you want to like disagree just because it's like they think it's gonna be the cool thing to do.
Mm-hmm. Well, you had those people like, oh, well, you know, it doesn't hold up to blase. Like, why are you trying to compare it to that? This can stand on its own.
I'm like, a movie that can stand by itself, people don't know how to appreciate, I feel, anymore. And that's a big deal for that cheese to stand alone and not come because, well, this movie before it or this movie that is going to be after it. It's just good.
It's on its own merit. Is what we should have gotten in the first place and what we should get going forward. Whether or not they do that, because again, DC wants to give you missionary position where they look you dead in your eye and give you
It's not DC. Rephrase it. It's WB.
Okay, I'm sorry. The WB wants to give you the dead fish. We give you boring stuff.
Trying to Michigan run. way too well.
Oh my God.
Look, he can sing and dance.
Every time.
But yeah, essentially, this is, like you said, this is the movie we should have gotten. And they said, oh, we're not going to do a sequel. I'm like, yeah, you dumb fucks. This is what got you in this position in the first place. And now you ended up, now you done turned around and paid the man $73 million. He gave you two films. He pretty much gave you two films just now. And it still performed better than the version you put out recently. And
it still is.
Yeah, and you and one of those dumbass execs said, oh, the reason why we didn't release this version is because it was much worse. How, Sway? Like, where was
that? Sway.
There you go.
Yeah, like, where, how is this worse?
How I get the answers, man?
Right.
Look, so, here's the thing. That's probably the same exec that wanted to try to get Zack Snyder out of there.
Yeah.
Because there's no way in hell you can tell me this, what we got that dropped on the 18th, is worse than what we got three years ago.
Yeah.
So we're looking 3 years ago. You dropped this bull crap ass thing where Wonder Woman came. You had all this other stuff. You had all these stories.
Her scene.
Yeah.
Like she goes into the bank. When she goes into the bank,
I have a theory.
There's a couple extra scenes that's added into that fight scene, and like they toned the color down a little bit, but it reads so much differently.
I have a theory, and when you watch I want you to think about this theory. There's a little girl in the movie who, in the first one, they didn't show. Like, this scene wasn't a part of it. And in this one, they show this little girl who comes out of nowhere. She has Mediterranean looks. She kind of looks like I'm not going to say Adana Man from Titans, but she kind of does look like her. And she says, hey, I want to be like you when I get older. Can I be like that? And Wonder Woman tells us you can be anything you want to be. I have a theory that's a young Donna Man.
Oh, you mean Donna Troy?
Donna Troy. Sorry, why I keep saying Donna Man? Donna Troy.
Yeah.
I don't know.
It reads so much. And that young was Donna Troy. It's almost a tear jerker. It's kind of like a, not tear jerker like watching Tony Stark die, but a tear jerker like, damn, it's a moment. You know, because this is Wonder Woman, you know, and a lot of women, you know, not a lot of women who are young girls watching Wonder Woman really viewed her as like, this is what we should be, you know.
Right. You know, at that time, she was still kind of be secret when she did her stuff.
Yeah. But the way she played, the way that scene played out, so much differently.
Way so better.
Differently.
They got rid of that dumbass lasso at the end when it was like, oh, we're a part of the Kidderon game and he's the leader with the fedora. They got rid of that part.
Yeah.
That was just stupid and unneeded.
But I just love what they've done. I love what Zach has done.
I love how they got rid of all that unnecessary, unneeded shit. Like, they did. Just didn't add anything to the story. It just felt like y'all threw it in just because y'all again wanted to cut out the good shit and just throw it
like in the funny scene that we got was during Barry saving Iris. It was a bit of a funny scene there.
That
was a scene there. The scene where, and me and my son laugh at it because it's just the way it looks. It's not meant to be funny, it's just it looks funny when they bring Clark back. And they're all trying to kind of calm him down, but it's not working because he's kind of going haywire a little bit. And Flash decides to run. He's thinking he's going to do a quick sneak. Clark kind of looks
like that one in the original.
Yeah, and the Clark got he looks out the corner of his eye, and then he looks like, at
oh,
him.
Shit.
And the way Barry looks, that
did he make eye contact?
They kept that scene from the original where you kind of see Clark just slow pan,
his head.
They kept that scene, and yeah, I liked that they kept that scene because that was good.
His reaction was like, "Oh shit!" You know, like this, that was a
psychological reaction when you're used to dusting people, and then you got somebody that locks eyes with Mr. Fast.
Not only locked eyes, but he kind of like turned.
He matched him in speed. He looked. He was like his eyes shifted over first, and then his whole head shifted. And Barry's look was like, "Oh,
okay, I didn't expect that."
So I mean, I know it wasn't meant to be funny, but his reaction was funny.
But then as the guy who plays Ezra Miller. He's funny.
Yeah, like, and you know what? I like him better now in this version, opposed to what we got because the other version. I'm
a lot of people like him better.
Now. he was the actor to me in DC's film world that can totally be the boy who played Peter Parker, in the sense of you're that kind of youth.
Kind of quirky, yeah,
like you're that for this. You guys match up, because I've seen him even outside of interviews, and it's like, this is just how you act.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, costume on you, gave you lines, but this is how you act.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so he reads a lot. His character development, way better. Cyborg, way better. Superman, way better. Everybody,
way better.
Fucking, look, the scene where Steppenwolf goes to Atlantis to get the mother box.
Yeah, there was a lot to that that wasn't in the original.
Aquaman got them hands. Okay, and he didn't even have the armor. He didn't even have the armor.
He had the hands.
No, that was just Jason Momoa.
I'm like, oh,
that was really Jason Momoa playing Jason Momoa at that time.
Jason Momoa playing Jason Momoa. I got the man. You just don't know.
He's like, what the fuck you say about Lisa Bonet? Okay,
pretty much. They were like, what is he doing? Just film it. Go.
Record.
He was Jason.
Yeah, they were like, this is Jason.
And the only thing that I did, I
get drunk and punch fish.
Right.
I want there to be a web series he really does, and it's just like called Punch Fish Jason.
Jason. He's jumping in water, start punching fish and shit.
Jason being Jason.
Trout.
I will say that.
And then they got to do interviews with the fish, like a shark gonna be like, "So I'm gonna
fucking come." I was minding my business.
I was trying to get a nigga
punch.
Got hit me in my black eye.
You see that nigga Jason? He tell him on sight, I'm gonna bite his ass.
So me and the family were swimming to Hawaii like we do every year, and this guy just jumps in the water
and punches my wife in the face.
Kind of weird ass.
My
kid in the nose. No, but what I can't
agree with the pussy, man. I don't understand.
I don't even know how he found it. No.
He can find it on a fish, man. That fucking bastard was looking for it.
But what I can appreciate, the one thing that they kept a couple scenes, and one thing they did keep is like Diana can handle Steppenwolf too. Like even in the other version, she was hanging with him.
Oh no, Superman put the paws to her.
Yeah.
I mean, like as a final, but yeah.
But, you know,
Superman put the paws to everybody, so let's not exclude everybody.
Yeah, they handle, you know what I noticed that they took out?
Remember that scene where Batman was talking about he had a backup plan for when he wake up Superman and it was supposed to be Lois?
Yeah.
That scene totally changed. It was like Lois just happened to be close by, which I like that better, because that made it seem like, you know what I'm saying? They did, because when you had Lois, like, oh, I got Lois as a backup plan, it made it seem like Batman knew what the fuck was going on, which in reality he shouldn't have, because there's some shit outside of his whole jurisdiction. You used to beat up niggas on the dock. Now you're a motherfucking alien expert and all this bullshit. Like,
He might come back a little nutty.
You know,
I'm not sure.
He beat up little John on the dock who just got a job defeat. You know what? Anyway, Batman's a bitch for beating up.
Those memes are hilarious. They got me like more and more not liking him, because I love Batman. But then I realized after reading those memes,
he beat up the low level ass niggas.
And I'm rocking the shirt right now because it's Batfleck. I mean, the dude, Ben Affleck can really. I'm really upset that he's not playing this role again.
Because they got sparkle vampire sparkle
fingers.
Now.
Sparkle fingers.
That doesn't think he has to work out. I don't have to lift weights and do that. I'm like,
bitch, please, you played a vampire who was a disco ball. Now you playing Batman.
I'm like, you can put on some
tights. How did he get this part? Is my question.
And they filming. They filmed rapping. They wrapped up filming.
They're done.
They're done.
Forever.
I don't see them. I don't see Matt Reeves.
They're gonna put a movie out. I don't want.
I do want to see Zoe's Catwoman. Although I already kind of feel like I know what I'm gonna get from her, but I still want to see it.
I'm gonna go out on a limb and say I don't feel like this film gonna be good.
Here's the thing. Before we get into Falcon and Winter Soldier, this is not a DC problem. This is a WB executive issue. These fuckers, you know, they just looking to see, like, do you know how much confusion you are causing
And we said that it's fucked up. It's like McAvoy and Stewart. Like, what the fuck is going on here?
It's like, do you know how much confusion you cause? Now, number one, when you said, okay, we're gonna add Flash to the Justice League film. Okay, you know how many different flashes carried that? You know how many people carried that actual moniker? Really, two. So you're like, all right, well, you already got Barry Allen on television. So we're thinking
Barry Allen on film.
Yeah, you're thinking it's going to be Wally West. No, it's going to be Barry Allen. So now take somebody who hasn't read any of the books and doesn't know the continuity, but they've watched the show. So now they're thinking, oh, this is Barry Allen. Oh, Barry Allen's going to wait.
You thought
that's wrong.
That's not the same guy. No, it's not the same. It's the same character. It ain't the same.
Then you had a crossover. Then you have two different Barry Allens.
Bye. Which was the only genius move they made.
That's how they fixed the continuity. But here's the other thing. Like, you've had 60 Batmans.
Man, listen.
Not in the now same you room. Got.
well, yeah. None of them have ever been seen together with Bruce Wayne either.
It's definitely true.
But, like, Robert Pattinson just don't feel like a Batman to me. Like, I just don't get it. Like, what would he appeal?
Where you think about not only just what you've seen him from, because outside of that, I've seen him act in some amazing films. So the acting is there. What I don't get is what we said Marvel does so well, where you're matching up somebody's background, personality outside of the role, their physicality.
I could have played Batman, look better as a Batman than him. This nigga look like a fucking skeleton in a suit.
Yeah, he's definitely a very gaunt looking.
Like Steve Rogers before the miracle serum.
Yeah, there's a difference between being thin, like kind of, I remember wispy? When they had a...
What's that word? Wispy?
That's how they describe soccer players. Wispy.
He's not built like those guys who are thinner, smaller, whatever, but the muscle's still there because they're swimmers or something. Or how in Batman Beyond, how he looks in the suit. You ain't thin like that and still looking athletic. You don't look athletic to me.
He doesn't even look like he can do anything.
Yeah, I'm not buying that you beat
like you're telling me you're telling me
this motherfucker's going through the night just beating people's ass, just popping in and out of the room. Fuck no.
Your arms are weak, dude.
This nigga got arms like this.
His arms
look like this. He can't even do a proper push-up and chin-up.
He go to punch. He punch a thug that's working on the dock in his job.
This is him trying to work out. Come on, Robert. Get it. Come on, Robert. We got to work out for Batman. I can't get it, man. My arms are too weak.
Muscle relaxes, man.
I don't find him believable. That's my only thing. Like, I do not find him fucking believable as Batman. And for them to try to tell me he's Batman is a slap in the face, like they've always been doing, like this whole time. They give you something good, then they slap you in the face and tell you.
And that is like people that are fans of DC. We're open to y'all every time y'all come back around like a toxic.
And we die.
It is. It's very toxic.
Like, okay.
This time you got himself together. It's gonna be different this time.
And he has my CDs in his car.
Meanwhile, Marvel is over here like, come on, man. You don't need to deal with that. Come on over here. You don't need to deal with that.
Marvel is death row right now. They're like, you tired of motherfuckers.
Changing up your continuity and giving you all kinds of
these weak ass Batman. Come on over here and watch Marvel films. We'll treat you right.
Pretty much. And people are going for it, too. Like, you know?
I fell for it because I was like, you know what? I like DC. You gave me Superman Returns. You gave me some good Superman movie. Other than not Superman Returns. Fuck Superman Returns. Man of Steel.
Man of Steel.
I correct myself because Superman Returns should never leave my lips as a good film. But you gave me Superman. You gave me Batman. You gave me Man of Steel. Okay. Okay. Cool. I'm with you. I ride with you. You won me back. Then you give me Batman versus Superman. That's cool. The roller coaster was nice, but then you give me this Ninja Turtle looking fucking Doomsday. I can forgive you for that. Then you give me Wonder Woman. It's like, oh, yes, I'm back. We're sleeping together tonight. You give me Aquaman. Okay, I'm giving it up on the first night now. And then it's like you gave me fucking Wonder Woman 2 in Justice League. And it was like, oh, you got to work. Get these draws off now, girl, because I'm not in the mood anymore.
These draws
off now.
Right. So we mentioned we did our Justice League spiel. Go see it. Check it out. Go see it. Just pull it up and watch it. Falcon and Winter Soldier, first episode. Mm-hmm. That opening, that
when I saw that, I was
that's like, a okay, badass action scene right there.
This is what people, which this is also something else funny because I have 10 more minutes left on that one, so don't mess that part up for me.
Wait till you see,
I see where it's going though, so I'm probably not going to be like, oh, with the ending.
Yeah. You will be.
What'd you say?
You will be.
You're not gonna be like, oh, but you're gonna be like, you're gonna be like, oh, these motherfuckers. I'm not
surprised. I will tell you this. When you see
that's where I'm more so leaning, Chris, because right now I feel like I feel like when this ends, I'm gonna be like, y'all some bullshit.
Yeah, right.
I'll say this. Look at dude's face when you.
That's the same. The look. What you said in his look is what it is. You're gonna be like
me and myself was like, who told him to make that fucking face? He looked weird.
I was just very saying, this is what I think it is, because my mind goes like that sometimes when I'm watching something. Like, what was the relevance in that?
This don't scare me. That's not a face of somebody who I'm supposed to fear.
Yeah,
he had a better chance.
I feel like was what people wanted.
Falcon has a face like at the end. Falcon has a face like these motherfuckers.
I'm not even talking about his face. I'm talking about
the other dude's face. Yeah,
yeah. He just got a weird. Like he just took the shit and ate a lemon at the same time. He just got a fucked up face. I know he was born with it.
Is that a new coin?
But it's not about his face. I just want to punch him in the face, man. I swear to God, I don't even know who the fuck he is, but I just wanted to punch him in the face.
You do like this. Face.
He's got a weird looking face. He's like, show me your tough face.
Oh, and then I noticed that there's this. there seems to be this running theme of everybody going to therapy in the MCU, and I'm just like, there's all of y'all need to be in therapy.
They are.
Yeah, they do. But yeah, seeing Falcon in that whole opening, what was it like? Maybe 10 minutes.
That was
a hell of a scene. Like mid-air scene that just like that further cements that Sam is such a badass in mid-air. Like he was putting their hands to shame.
I was like, y'all got money. Like, this is how I want all my TV shows to be. Cause I'm like, this is giving me mini movie, and I'm writing for the cinematography, but I'm like, y'all got money. But what I thought about, I ain't gonna lie, like maybe 10 minutes in or so. Also like that it's almost an hour. But I felt like automatically people that were on the fence about WandaVision, this is what they were expecting from WandaVision as far as action, like every other episode or from the very first episode.
Yeah.
This is what a lot of those people that just didn't get that show and was like, this is trash. How y'all start off like this? Y'all were going to love the Winter Soldier. Like I knew it. You're going to love Falcon and the Winter Soldier. Cause I think they're just going to keep running with this because those fight scenes are crazy. It helped me still get over how upset I am about Daredevil, but that's another topic. Mm-hmm. But I love close cut fight scenes. I love getting flashbacks that help develop a character better.
The flashbacks are really
helping, because I'm not gonna lie, I was never really here for Bucky. And now I'm like, sir, you had a greasy haired, you know, tragic lifestyle. Like you were going through. Because this hair always
is My Chemical Romance.
It's very My Chemical Romance. Very giving.
Very hot topic.
Very hot topic.
But, I mean, that finding out that backstory. That was so fucked. Because I was thinking at first, I'm like, oh, that must be like one of the men that he probably saved.
I thought it was just like a regular nightmare. Like, I thought it was just some shit he was dreaming about. Find out that wasn't no dream like he was having, that's something he just did. Me and my son was like, oh, shit. Because me and my son watched it together.
Yeah.
He didn't want to watch Justice League because he didn't want to do the 4 hours, but he had time for Winter Soldier. But anyway, as he called it, Captain Soldier and the Winter Falcon.
Which would still probably make a pretty good
show still. But no, that twist in the first, the way they came out with that first twist is like, okay, you killed this dude, and now you got to go back and make amends. So you've been hanging out with this guy trying to tell him that you killed his son, which everybody, when I first saw it, I'm like, okay, he just had a weird dream. Maybe it was a dream. Maybe this didn't really happen.
Yeah, I thought it was a dream. It
happened.
Yeah, I thought it was a dream, and then when they showed the old Asian dude, I thought it was like, is this like one of his war buddies that's still alive?
Still alive. I just thought it was like somebody.
Because you think about that time frame, and you're like, they could be alive. So what's that?
Yeah,
somebody.
Like if Steve is still running around, so obviously one of these guys is. It's not that many of them left, but it's got to be
106. I just thought it was somebody in the neighborhood he just happened to befriend just because, you know, he feels like an old spirit inside.
But yeah,
you know, his body's like 34, but his
what he said he was like 106.
Yeah. I'm like, he don't know nothing about dating and all this other stuff, so he related better with this old guy. That's what I thought. Come to find out, you got to tell him and apologize that you killed his son.
And he damn near came close. And but when he seen him, but it wasn't until that old dude said, he says, what's wrong? And he's like, oh, my son used to like eating red bean mochi. And I'm like,
I think he knew before then, though. He knew before then, though, because he had him on that list.
No, no. I mean, when Bucky knew.
Well, what we found out is people,
I was like,
list kind of messed it up, yeah.
Yeah. When he said that and he was talking about how his son was wrong place, wrong time, I'm like,
yeah, okay, oh, that's what it made sense to me. I was like, oh shit, that's his son he killed. Okay, I'm like, maybe he really killed him.
I'm like, how many more therapy sessions are you gonna need? Because
apparently a lot more, because him and Sam go to one together. We got to get to that.
Oh, they're going to get it. We ain't even got there yet.
That's what I'm saying. This is only six. But the crazy part, this is only six episodes, so they're really about to give us a lot in six episodes, I can feel. Yeah.
Oh,
they're not playing. It's only six. They're not playing games.
Quickly.
They trying to get to everything else. They was like, you know what? We get y'all 9 with Wanda, because that set up something bigger. You're going to get a 6 here, but we're going to jam-pack this shit because it's going to give y'all something bigger later on so we can set some more up with it.
Yeah, because between Loki and... Because I'm so ready for that. Like, I'm enjoying...
They got Armor Loki, Wars.
She-Hulk. They got She-Hulk. She-Hulk, Moon Knight, Hawkeye. Moon Knight,
yeah.
This ain't even in order. Secret Invasion.
Armor Wars.
I'm like, they're just Loki. They're
Disney
just saying,
Plus is about to load. They're lining just up. Those are just the shows.
Yeah. There's like, you know, we're giving you
meanwhile, right now. Movie wise, they got Ant-Man 3, Spider-Man, Doctor
Black
Strange,
Widow,
Black Widow.
They got us waiting on
Shang-Chi.
Yeah, yeah.
In the Ten Rings.
Ant-Man and Quantumania, Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania. They're not Shang-Chi. They're not pulling no punches.
Like, Marvel just said they about to be going busy all year long.
Pretty much.
Like, they're like, we've had one whole year where you didn't get nothing from us.
We about to bust all over the place. The fish tank, the TV. Y'all about to get all this love in the night.
You just say, y'all.
Hey, Marvel, you want to go to the room? We're going to go to the room. We're going to get any plus. We're going to go to the movie theater.
Like Star-Lord said, he was like, if you put a black light in here, it's going to be looking like a Picasso painting all over.
Oh, my God.
He said Jackson Pollock painting.
Yeah, that was creepy. But anyway, it still was funny.
Yeah, look, they're not playing around, though. They just.
And again, that's why Marvel has surpassed DC. Because they're not. One, they don't play games.
They
ain't scared to take no risks. And three, they don't give a fuck how you feel. You either going to like it or we're going to put it down your throat and you're going to love it later.
Pretty much, and they're going to spare no expense. You never hear about them making a film, and they're like, well, budget cuts because they were being too cheap. They're like, what you need?
Marvel's like, oh, like, we got cuts. Disney money. Like, hey, we budget. Got ESPN money.
That's yeah, what's the like. Budget cut? What
the
budget
only thing we're money? Cutting is these checks, son.
Imagine walking into a boardroom meeting. You're like, how much money are we making today, Mr. Feige? Oh,
pretty much.
Tons. We got, you know that, you know
I
how
got
we
plenty money. Kevin Feige out here like
you know how we got, you
I got
how we got
money.
You know how we got DuckTales? They were like, yeah, remember Scrooge McDuck swimming in all exactly. them coins?
Imagine Kevin Feige at his house right now. It's the dead of summer, almost somewhere, wherever he's at, because he's like 4 seasons ahead, because he got that good money.
Good money.
He got enough money so you can just transcend seasons.
You can choose your
I want it to be summer so I can swim in my pool with all these millions of dollars.
Pretty much. Which side though? Scrooge McDuck should have been hurt because I'm thinking about jumping into that many coins.
Yeah.
That's dense.
Family Guy showed that whole true story to that. That nigga should have been dead.
I think about that now. I'm like, it hurt to have someone throw a nickel at you, let alone you die.
How the fuck? You swimming in coins.
If you've ever seen the Hobbit, The Desolation of Smaug,
I did.
And okay, the part where Bilbo Baggins is in the inside the basically the castle where the dragon is, where Smaug is at, all those coins, and he's looking for one. That's what Kevin Feige's in right now. He's just like,
he's definitely in there.
You know what's crazy though? When you say that name, I always thought his name was Bilbo Baggins.
Bye.
I swear to God. I thought his name was Dildo Baggins. I swear to God. I heard that.
No sense for a movie this big.
Hey, man, I didn't know how big it was at the time. I just heard a nigga named Bilbo Dildo Baggins. And I was like, oh.
Huge deals.
That's another movie.
maybe it was the Pornhub version of it. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm sure that one's out there.
Dildo Baggins hers.
No, anywho. That one. But, yeah,
what
Marvel and Disney, you know, I remember that merger first going down, and people were afraid that Marvel was going soft. And
it was a concern because they're just like, all right, how Disney is this gonna go?
Yeah.
Like, what does it mean for us?
And they're just like,
it means more money, motherfuckers.
Okay.
Somebody was in there smart. They was
money,
like, no,
money.
we need to sign this paper because we about to make tons of it. And
but that just goes to show, again, why Marvel is going to be better than DC for the next couple of years to come, because they got the backing. Like, they got the next 40 years on lock. Like, these motherfuckers might not get until we gone and don't remember this shit to where DC can actually make a comeback. 2020-30 and shit, these motherfuckers finally made a good movie, but nobody's here to see it. That matters because all the
somewhere we're gonna be dead and gone, and our great grandchildren gonna be playing with Ouija boards, and I'm gonna be like, hey, y'all still
Grandpa,
got the Marvel movies man. Coming out. Take them over to the movie theater with you. I want to see it.
Marvel's going to be doing so well. We're going to be able to see so many different phases of our favorite characters. So when we're 80, we're going to be able to say, I remember when Tony played Iron Man. They're going to be recasting.
Yeah, Ringy Ree Williams and fucking the Asian Hawk. Like, it's
going to be so many
different. I'm a Danish toy.
They got that Asian boy.
They have a pretty good Asian boy.
I was wondering about that one.
Not an Asian boy.
Remember that Asian boy, Amadeus? He ever get his time?
What are you talking about, Amadeus?
Getting in the chair like Amadeus Cho.
Sit down, let me tell you a story.
Tell you a story about a boy named Amadeus. Who was Asian. Grandpa, we don't believe you. Shut up.
Shut up and a smack or something.
Shut up, boy.
Pretty much. What did
he say, Family Guy? He was gay. Grab your ankles and grab the nearest pole kind of gay. Not that like newfangled stuff y'all got now.
Yeah, that was
Family Guy. That's how you tell
the
story.
That's a definition of gay that you've never heard before. But closing out.
Marvel is going to Marvel is the golden standard now for
it is
absolutely.
One, how to make a movie, two, how to tell a story, and three, how to weave all these different stories into one end game. Like, fuck it. Like, you can't even say it.
You can't say no other way.
10 years of movies, one after the other, that seem insignificant but kind of had parts that made them intertwine, but at the same time, they told a story. Avengers, it kind of introduced Thanos. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it's crazy because, like, you look back, like, even Ultron kind of told the story of the Scarlet Witch going forward. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like,
and would you believe it was their? I think Age of Ultron was possibly their weakest performed movie, and it still made a ton of money.
No, yeah, exactly. I will say that I liked Age of Ultron.
I
had to watch it more than once, and I think for me, what I liked about it was there were iconic moments in it where it's like, that's not a movie you skip because you would not have been able to appreciate.
Captain's still trying to choke a robot, though. I still can't.
That's where they lost me.
But you was trying to choke a robot.
So yeah, have moments like that, that was the scene that stood out to me most, because I'm like, you guys really do seem like if you did have these powers in real life, you'd be drinking together and trying to do some dumb shit like this. Mm. Like, this, it was a perfect scene. I'm like, that.
Yeah, the hammer scene was good.
Yeah,
it was good, and it was great to have.
But it also was a precursor because you had Cap who almost lifted it, and then you had him in Endgame holding that motherfucker like it was his own.
It definitely was his.
So again, that's why I say they can able to tell these stories and give you these little moments that seem like nothing, but in the grand scheme of things, over these 10 years, they gave you hints of things to come. We just didn't pay attention to it because
but it makes you want to watch your stuff again, and that also
or you had to go back for the replay value because you have to go back. I got told Chris watching Justice League, there was shit I probably missed. Even while we was on the phone and I was watching, I was like, I'm gonna have to go back and watch that because I'd have missed it now and I ain't about to stop. So I'm gonna have to go back and catch it. So they were able to set up this universe, set up this the way of storytelling that one made sense and two gave you little hints, big hints, and everything in between to where you either had to pay attention or you had to know what was going on, or you had to go back and watch the entire thing again just to catch up. So when they gave you the big bad in this, the grand finale, the culmination of all this hard work that all these movies set up, it was like, damn, they really know how to set up a fucking thing. Like the payoff was worth like, it.
Payoff was, man, listen.
I mean, here it is. Here it is, what, almost 2 years later, the payoff is still amazing.
On my cable thing I have, you know, is this thing called 24/7. They have like 24/7 movie things, and they have an Infinity Wars, and it starts from like chronologically and goes all the way to Endgame and then starts over again. So it's just like 24/7 from the beginning, the whole phase one, Captain Marvel, all of it.
Okay.
They show
I like that.
Captain Marvel.
Right.
You know, they show it in chronological order how it would have happened in time. You know what I mean? Like, yeah,
thing that makes their movies cool.
So they setting up this timeline.
But see that, yeah, like you said, that's another thing that makes their movies cool because they have communication. They're like, we're doing this, and like just like with Captain Marvel, we're just like, oh, and it's taking. He's saying, oh, it takes place during the 90s. Okay, whatever. And we watching him like, I see why. Just like with Black Widow, when we finally get Black Widow in May, we're just like, okay, this took place before Infinity War. Obviously, this took place. I think it was after, was it Iron Man?
Probably
Civil War. It's Civil War. Yeah, Civil War. So you're getting an in between. But the question is, they're not telling us why we're getting this now, but we know there's a reason.
It's a setup.
Yeah, we don't know what it is.
I'm not even gonna question no more. I know everything's gonna set. It's gonna set something up.
They just said like it was announced that everything that we see, like nothing's insignificant. You may think like, why did that happen? This was dumb. And it's like, no, you may have to wait 3 shows, but this is gonna come back around. Just give it 10 years. Or
3 years.
Yeah. I mean, just like. Like I know through comic lore that there have been 2 Black Widows, and I know in this one you get introduced to Yelena. I don't know if that's part of the issue where they're introducing this second widow.
Or she comes because
like we've been wrong. WandaVision has proven that.
The whole first phase proves that.
You know, so
a lot of motherfuckers wrong about the first phase, what was going on and what happened and was supposed to happen. It was
look, Mandarin. Talk about
we didn't even get the real Mandarin. We thought we was got screwed, but they did it on purpose. Yeah. So they could set up another Mandarin.
The actual Mandarin.
These motherfuckers are playing 3-dimensional chess, like where you got the three chess.
we're gonna give them the fake one on
branch purpose. Off and do both of those iconic franchises so well. I'm looking at DC like, what y'all gonna do? Like, y'all want to see a dead body? Like, it's so bad because it's like
you're taking a cold shower with the dick in your hand. This is like real weird
I think that's why there's always going to be this underdog Cleveland Brown energy attached to DC. because it's like
they like the Detroit Lions right now. They like,
we want to see you win. We want to see you win. You have some of the most iconic characters in comic book history to help you win. And you're just fumbling the ball every time.
Fumbling like these niggas got fucking greasy hands trying to catch a wet pig. Like you know what I'm saying? Like it just
you just got done eating a whole bucket of fried chicken without even washing hands afterwards, and now you're
going perfect movie. Whoops.
Right.
Oh, we got Superman. Oh God, how do we do this?
What are we doing?
Yeah. What do we do?
I don't know how to make this movie.
But
bring in Josh Whedon.
Like, I do, and they're like, get out of here.
Yeah. Here's DC executives.
They're like, oh my God, this is terrible. Somebody please. Find Ja Rule, get hold of this motherfucker so I can make sense of all this.
I can't
this.
Make sense of how to make a good Superman movie. Oh, Jesus.
Is it the character? I mean?
Like, where's... I don't know. I mean, it's so much stuff I can use and so many backstories I can say about this guy, but, you know, just making him seem
I'm going to make his suit orange, and then I'm going to give him fuchsia pants. And like, why? Why are you doing any of this?
Let's give him a son named Ophis.
Oh, and then they turn around. Oh, we're gonna reboot it. No, don't.
Again. You know, give me 60 Batmans, five Supermans.
Like, look, go with your tails between your legs. Go to Henry Cavill. Go to Zack Snyder. Go to Ben Affleck. And
yeah, it's about rebooting it.
And just say,
making him black.
Let's continue, please, Mr. Cavill, Mrs. Godot, and. Can we just continue on with the pattern? Snyder would just
let you so good. Please let us back.
Yeah.
So sorry. You said reach around? Okay.
Yeah, we won't touch it again. Like, you shouldn't touch it at all. Just let these
people. Hands off. Blindfold yourself. Hands off. Put your hands behind your back and just let us do our thing. Yeah. Sit back and take it.
But on that note, we were in closing. We are... What are we like in mid season? Actually, we're gonna go what I think the full 10 episodes for Blurs Eye View After Dark. So
okay.
Yeah, because that way we can finish off Falcon and Winter Soldier. We are taking a break next week, so that means the week after that, we get to talk about two episodes. So it works out. Closing out, what do we got, Candy B? What you working on?
I'm about to do two things. Finishing Golden Goddess stuff. I had to order new bottle droppers. Long story. Doing your own business is rough. Salute to everyone that does it because, oh my God. Mm-hmm. It is not easy. I'm going to shout out DC.
You're talking to those who know.
What'd you say?
You're talking to those who know.
Yeah, I'm like, I've never done this. I'm like, this is more stressful than when I was selling Girl Scout cookies. Just stressful. I'm just like, I need a box of Thin Mints right now. But I wait for labels because I'm not printing my own. So I'm waiting for labels and getting that done. I'm hoping to have a couple of fun cosplays done and some pictures up to launch the CandyB_cosplay page because I've been asked for the longest to have a separate page. And I kind of like the idea of having like my alter ego separated from my main meme page. So those are the two things I'm working on: getting this shmoney and getting my cosplay out there.
DC,
huh? Oh, sorry. It's been a long day. It's been a long week. Hey, you know, just out here living life.
Yeah, basically.
Oh, yeah, we know Mr. Spike Cares.
New watches, got another car.
New watch ass.
That's a Nike 6 Plus.
A couple kids, don't you? All them skinny.
Actually, my insurance. So what happened was, shout out to AT&T because I called them. I was supposed to call them, like, and I kept putting it off. So apparently, something told me to put it off. So I was like, "Hey, yeah, you know, I need another watch. My watch broke. I didn't tell them how." But anywho, so my watch broke.
So the blurs have you after dark.
So my watch broke. And then I was like, hey, I need another watch. They're like, oh, okay, what do you have? Told them what I had. They're like, oh, yeah, we're out of the fives. All we got is this Nike 6 Plus. And I was like, okay, hey, upgrade, same price. But anywho.
I know that's right. See? It worked out.
Yeah. Okay. Anywho, tomorrow is a wonderful day. It is the end of season 2 for What the Shit, which is big. It's huge.
That's a huge deal.
Considering we weren't supposed to make it past the first season. Let alone, you know, we were supposed to watch what we say. But we got illustrious guests tomorrow. We got G Black. We got my guy Miller. We got my guy Mario. I got a guy who started his own podcast. And the topic is being Black in America and our contribution to society. So that's our main topic for tomorrow. So I'm looking forward to that.
Cool.
In the meantime, go. Huh?
No, go ahead.
I thought Brandon was going to
ask me. No, I did. I said that's going to be a good one.
Yeah,
I can't wait because I know my guy Mario is pro-Black. I mean, everybody's going to be pro-Black, but I know there's going to be a lot of different opinions. But that's the thing about, you know, the show. It's no one safe and there's no, you know, cutting corners. We're going to tell it like it is and, you know, keep it real. So
I'll be wearing the Miramar obligatory Black Panther gear.
I'm wearing my black hoodie.
I got to be. I'm all, you know me. This is Chris Fury. This is Blurred's Eye View After Dark. You can catch us, not next week, because we're taking a break on from Blurred's Eye View and Blurred's Eye View After Dark, but we will be following back up the following week. So if you like what you're seeing, if you like what you're hearing, check out the YouTube page, Blurred's Eye View. Hit that notification bell. Subscribe to the channel. There you go. Do the same thing for the Facebook page, Instagram, Blurred's Eye View, Blurred's underscore Eye View, all lowercase. You can check us out in any past episode on Spotify, Apple's podcast, Google podcast. We are making moves, baby. Stay with us. We will be continuing showcasing. And if you got something for us to showcase and you're a person of color and you got something you want to get out there, there you go. We all about the support. So until next time, educate yourself and others, entertain yourself and others, and most of all, encourage yourself and others. And until next episode, this is General Chris Fury with Candy B and DC, and we are out.